morning, everyone. Welcome to another fun and exciting lesson here at Kids Hope. Let's all stand close our eyes in prayer. Father Lord Jesus, we just want to thank you for this day. Mighty God, we thank you for keeping all of us here at Kids Hope, our families, our friends, safe in your mighty hands. Father Lord Jesus, we just thank you for your guidance during the coming week. We give you all the praise, the glory, and the honor. So now, my babies, it's time for some exercise, and we have to praise our Lord. Are you ready to praise your Lord? I can't hear you. Are you ready to dance for Jesus? Very good. Hope you have your comfy shoes on. Let's praise our Lord. After that, we will be getting into our lesson. So get your pens, papers ready for an interesting lesson today. Till later, let's get ready to praise our Lord. Again, our lesson for today is on good thoughts, bad thoughts. I wonder if you ever heard that on our shoulders or next to our ears there are two angels. One is a bad angel and he'll give you bad thoughts and bad ideas, and on the other side there's a good angel who'll give you good thoughts and want you to do what is right. What determines you from being a good person? Do you know? Okay, it's not the clothing that we wear, it's not the expensive watch that we wear, or the very nice cap that we're wearing. No, It determines your character. It is also what you believe in your heart, which will make you have good thoughts, which will make you want to be more like God. So often we think, do I want to do right? Do I want to do bad? Now there's my friend who has two beautiful pens, pencil colors, or whatever she has, and I want it because I don't have it. Now, the two angels are sitting on your shoulder and they're telling you, take it. The bad one is telling you, take it, take it. The good one on the other side is like, no, don't, it is wrong. Good thoughts, bad thoughts. Now remember that. Proverbs 23 verse 7 says, Proverbs 23 verse 7 says, a person thinks in his heart, and so will he be. What does that mean? A person thinks with his heart, and so will he be. If you're thinking good thoughts, it comes from your heart. You'll do what's right. You always want to do what's right. You wouldn't want to do what is bad now, would you? No, we wouldn't. When we think good, we do good. When we think bad, we do bad. So, do you know the story of Adam and Eve? Yes, I'm sure we all do know that story of Adam and Eve. So Adam and Eve lived in this garden, in this beautiful garden that God has given them. But God also gave them an instruction and he said, do not eat from the tree of knowledge. They lived happy. For years they lived happy, walking around the garden, eating the fruits, just being happy, praising God. And every afternoon, God would come and they would have a chat. Okay? One day, the serpent came, the devil. He came in the form of a snake and he told Eve, go and eat from the tree of knowledge and you and Adam will also become like God. That was the wrong decision. It was wrong of him to come and say that, but he came and he wanted to deceive them. He wanted them to do what's wrong. So what did Eve do? She was thinking and she was thinking. And then she and Adam ate from the tree of knowledge. And this was wrong. It was terrible. One, Eve disobeyed God. They had bad thoughts. Number two, they believed in Satan instead of God. Number three, they had unpleasant feelings. They were in fear. They felt guilty. They had done something terrible, which made them feel that way. Now, good thoughts comes from God. Bad thoughts comes from Satan. Good thoughts will always lead us into righteousness, into right feelings. Now, let's all stand up quickly. Now, say to yourself, God loves me. I am precious to God. I always want to be his child forever. That's good. Now let's say that again. God loves me. I am precious to him. I always want to be his child. Now, when you realize this, you will know that how much God loves you. And this should only make you want to love God more, to want to make Him more happy. Okay, now our memory verse for today is on Romans 8:31. Romans 8:31. If God is for me, who can be against me? Let's all say it together. Romans 8:31. If God is for me, who can be against me? Let's add some actions to it. If God is for me, who can be against me? Romans 8:31. If God is for me, who can be against me? Very good. While we're standing, let's all close our eyes in prayer. Thank you, Father, for giving me wisdom to do the right thing and to have right thoughts. Thank you for giving me the decision to make right thoughts. Help and guide me into the path of righteousness. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen and amen. Till next week, my babies. Have a good week. Bye. Love you.